Real Men of Real Estate with Steve Matley, construction manager and real estate developer, business owner and educator.
Did you know that right now there's 22,000 units deficit?
Tunde Ogunwole, real estate development professional, Naval Academy grad, and veteran with a deep understanding of the public sector process.
All of us want to live in thriving communities.
Brian Fox, real estate expert and investor dedicated to helping hundreds of clients make money in real estate every year.
There's so much housing going in.
The builders are begging for more land.
Future company can come in, lease up space to employ those people who are living in the homes.
We have to put the housing in place.
Either we either have to have houses,
they want to make sure that there's a strong employment logistics center,
things like information hubs. We are a shipping economy now. There's economies all over the country where their prices are doubling and tripling.
Welcome, everybody. This is Real Men of Real Estate. And as we're all well aware, we are on quarantine for the time being. And so the team and I decided that we would start doing some Facebook Live, some webcasts, and some Zoom meetings to talk about what's going on in the real estate market so we can hopefully keep panic to a low minimum and we can give very good education as to what's going on in and around us so you know what to do with your real estate decisions moving forward. I am Brian Fox, and with me always is Stephen Matley and Tunde Ogunwole. And today we're actually going to jump into the recently released $3 trillion stimulus package. We're going to go through those bullets really quickly and discuss how this will affect real estate and what you should come to expect of it. So welcome all. Anybody want to start this thing off with what they like most of the stimulus package, or should I just go down the list?
Well, Brian, why don't you start off with giving us a couple bullet points on what it means, because the people listening may not know all the details in this.
Sure. So right off the bat, the thing I think we've talked about or heard about most is the direct payment to individuals. So direct payment to everyone, if you make $75,000 and less, you're entitled to a $1,200 payment as an individual and $2,400 as a couple, and $500 per child up to the age 17. And that is for $75,000 and less, and it phases out at $100,000 and more. So after $100,000 in gross income on your tax returns, you get no money. So that is the first thing. The next is student loan payments being suspended. And Department of Education would suspend payments of student loan borrowers without penalty through September 30th, according to the bill. As of right now, the Real ID that we've all been hearing about for the last year is going to be delayed indefinitely until we know what's coming next. Historic boost in unemployment benefits. They're going to give jobless workers an extra $600 per week for 4 months. So not a lot more money, but a little bit more money. And then some of the big stuff is $500 billion lending program, which they're going to be giving through state-specific and SBA financing. One of the big deals was that none of the Trump administration could benefit from the stimulus package, meaning that none of his companies can get anything, which is interesting. No money for the border wall. Airlines and airports would get what they need, which is $32 billion in grants for wages and benefits in a declining industry. Hospitals get billions. Contractors and gig workers would get some money on the side, but not a lot, and that's kind of up to negotiation. $25 million for the Kennedy Center, and let's see, and various other small things kind of littered in, as well as some state-specific stuff that they'll add out, and the SBA giving small business loans to help get through any economic downturn. So that is, in a nutshell, the stimulus package. And I don't know, I think that this will have a short-term effect on what's going on, but long-term, I think that we'll have to deal with this some ways out, because we've got to pay back this money. What do you guys think?
You know, I think a couple of things that come to mind. Obviously, this is fresh and new, and people are just listening to the information, maybe for the first time hearing it from us, the Real Men of Real Estate, or they're seeing it on the news. I think what's reminiscent for me is that I remember the activities around late summer 2007 and 2008, when we were going through this economic downturn at that time. And one of the things that I think is really beneficial about the stimulus package is there's a coordinated effort to increase the volume of money in circulation in the United States. And obviously, our administration and many people around know that just within a couple weeks, we've been significantly impacted by people staying at home, not being able to frequent some of the businesses. Some of you who are listening to this may have either been let go or furloughed or seen some significant reductions in your own lifestyle. And so to see that government is really trying to put money in circulation and get money moving and have carrots in there in terms of deferring when people repay some of their debt in order to focus on keeping the economy going, I think that's encouraging. Mm-hmm. I think from a commercial real estate and logistics standpoint, we talked about this in one of our other episodes, that for those people who are still buying those essential goods, whether it's food or healthcare supplies or whatever, much of those transactions are happening online. So there's an opportunity to not only take that $1,200 or $2,400 check or things like that that are in the stimulus package, but see that there's some opportunity. We're going to be buying goods in a different way. We're going to interact with people in a different way. And this stimulus package on a high level shows the country's recognition of that.
What do you think, Steve?
I think it's interesting, some of what's in and some of what's out. It's interesting to me, they specifically stated that Trump's companies could not benefit, which is fine, although he has companies that do have employees that are service workers, because he owns hotels and casinos and golf courses. So those people would be probably out of work like everyone else. But they didn't exempt the companies that all the different Congress people are have. I'm thinking they should have been a blanket statement. If you are part of the legislature or the executive branch, you cannot benefit from this. Make it a blanket statement. I think it's interesting they specifically called out the Kennedy Center. Obviously, somebody's got some influence somewhere. That's a little bit strange, because that would be a blanket entertainment venue should probably be included there. The no border wall is strange, because that's a construction project. And construction workers, a lot of them are hourly workers that are doing steel and concrete work. Just that may not be a popular project, but it is in fact a federally contracted project with construction workers, whether we like it or don't like it. Those people still need to have benefits too. Now, interestingly enough, in most places, housing construction is considered essential, and that is continuing. That is continuing to work. So those employees are still working, so they may not need to have this stimulus package. I like the lending going through the SBA, because that talks directly to the small businesses, and the small businesses have been hit very hard. All the little mom and pop restaurants and shops and bed and breakfast and all the, you know, the kiosks in the malls and in the airports and those kind of things, that hits them very hard. So having those loans available, hopefully at low to no interest. What I would have really liked to see in this bill, above anything else, honestly, would have been a suspension of all elected officials' payroll until we're back to normal again. That would have been one of the biggest benefits we could have done. That's a lot of money right there. So
yeah, I think that, well, the other question too on this is that, you know, as it pertains to real estate, so if they're, another side of this that's not a part of this, but they issued government orders. We were just talking about this before for Fannie Mae and Freddie Mac and rental leases to not suspend people, evict people, or foreclose. Well, if they're doing that and they're pumping this other bit of money into people, it's tough to say if this is going to be a long-term conclusion or we're going to see this stuff show up later when these loans run out and people may or may not get back on their feet like they think they can, and they issue these loans, are they going to forgive them all? I mean, if someone is a business owner and they do try to get back on the feet, but they just can't, at that, what point does that come?
Yeah, this is more of a deferral than a forgiveness. And so somewhere down the road, this all has to come back only. And what my concern would be is we have deferred rents and deferred payments and taxes, but does that all become a huge series of balloon payments that all of a sudden is due in late summer, early fall, that's going to cripple people who aren't prepared for that. I wonder if that's going to, maybe that's a whole nother package that has to come out at that point because it's another emergency. On the other hand, I do see a potential here for a huge boom in production. There is going to be a lot of pent up demand. You know, I look at this whole thing as you built a temporary dam across a river and the river didn't stop flowing. All you did was just stop what was going downstream. As soon as you remove that dam, you're going to get a flood run downstream. And that's that pent up demand that we have to restock everything. Now, granted, once we restock everything, if people that afforded a lot of stuff, they won't need to buy a lot of new things. But I'll tell you where the real push is going to be is people getting out of their houses and out socializing again. I see a big push on vacations.
Let's talk a little bit about that. Where do you see those opportunities, right? So, I mean, obviously people are recognizing the here and now and they've been restricted in their movement. You touched on it. They're not traveling. They're not, so any industry that's affected by travel is directly impacted. Mm-hmm. So when you talk about the boom, I hear entertainment, I hear mm-hmm. restaurants, I hear, you know, socializing in groups instead of socializing like we are, we're doing it in person. I see those as opportunities down the road. When you talk about some of the pent up demand, do you want to highlight something that as a person who's listening to this and trying to figure out where can I benefit? Where are some of the opportunities? What are some of the thoughts that you've got?
Well, what you just mentioned, travel and entertainment. So because the majority of the population are more extroverted type personalities. They feed on social interaction. Humans are mostly designed to interact with each other. Even the most introverted people can't live by themselves. They have to have interaction with people. We're designed that way. And when you isolate that for too long, that need has to be filled. And so people are going to go out and do restaurants and the clubs and the bars and the theaters and the, you know, whatever, the networking events and conferences and all the stuff that got canceled. They're going to have to make up for that. Vacations. There's going to be a lot of that pent up. But I also look at the supply chain. All the empty shelves in every store across, in every town across the country has to get refilled again. And so whatever those products are, have to get refilled. All the restaurants that close are going to have to restock all at the same time while the stores are restocking. So that's cleaning supplies, paper products, food products, all that stuff going on at the same time. All the hotels having to restock. So I see a big boom in those type of things. I would look at companies like, you know, Kimberly-Clark, they make diapers and toilet paper and paper towels. And
let's swing this back to real estate though. So the question I would have as we go into the last couple months that we're doing this for, how do we see this having an impact in real estate? Do we think this is actually going to be a beneficial thing? Like everyone was worried about real estate going down and the stimulus package became a part of the new plan and therefore real estate is going to be okay. Does it matter at all? With the last couple minutes I have, let's each go around the table quick. And I'd like to get your thoughts first, Steve, and then Tunde, and then I'll go last. But what do you think?
I think real estate, first of all, you have people that are unable to go out and list and sell their homes right now, and they're still going to have a need. There's still a desire to do that. So that's going to get caught up, plus going into the summer season, which is when it's busy anyways. That's number one. Number two, people are reassessing right now the arrangements where they live because they're having to work at home. Their kids are doing school at home, and they're reassessing, do they have enough space? Do they have place to work? I think a lot of people may not end up going back to work where they work because their jobs are going to decide, you know what, this worked out pretty well with you being remote and it saved us a lot of overhead. So maybe now they permanently have to work at home and now they need a space. So I think people will reevaluate and you may see an increase in people basically buying properties that fit a slightly changed lifestyle.
Okay. Tony, what do you think?
My thought is that this stimulus package is directly aimed at minimizing what's going to happen over the next few months. The focus right now with the stimulus is to minimize the damage and the downturn that could happen without it in the next few months. We typically have a longer term view than the next few months. And I think the benefit of the stimulus package, most of the items that are in there are to encourage people to find creative opportunities. If you're not going back to the job that you may have recently been laid off or furloughed, find an opportunity to try to find income some other way. So I think this is really aimed at keeping people from being in a dark place in the short term. I think the opportunities that Steve talked about earlier in entertainment, if you're a person who's looking at real estate and you're trying to find real estate plays and maybe you don't have enough capital set aside, look at some stocks in hotels and say, recognize that some of those hotel stocks probably have dipped. Airline stocks have dipped. In the future, that activity will come back. So I think in 6 months or so, you'll start seeing things start to climb. But in the short term, I think the stimulus is really aimed at minimizing the damage of what's already been happening and what Congress and the government's projecting over the next few months.
So I'm inclined to agree with you a little bit, I think. So if I'm looking at this, it obviously doesn't focus on real estate, but what we're really trying to say is real estate just kind of one of those things people spend money on when they have the money. And we're trying not to let the money go short. And so they want to keep the faucet on. So getting them whatever window of opportunity they can for the cash we can give you so you can keep moving keeps the real estate market fresh and it keeps people wanting to get out there and do things. You know, people who get laid off, they might have been in contract on a property 4 days ago. They had no idea they're going to be laid off. And so it's the ability to have certainty in how far in the future I can see my job continuing. And so many people would never buy a job, buy a house right now because they're unemployed, even though they could be employed tomorrow. But there's uncertainty there. So I think this gives them a sense of certainty in what they'll have available to them that I can keep business going for how long, and the market will correct when this coronavirus thing goes away. And we'll all be good together in about 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 months. And so that's kind of the way that I would show it up. So that's about all we have. Do you guys have any final thoughts you want to add?
Just a summary on that. Real estate's long-term.
Yeah.
Stock market is short-term and it reacts emotionally. Real estate is long-term and this is a short-term problem. So I don't see it having a huge effect immediately.
Okay, good.
My final thought is really what you did, Brian, earlier is great in terms of making sure people understand what's in the stimulus package. That's number one, understand what's in it. And then have a bias towards what's the opportunity, which is very difficult. If you've lost your job, or if you're taking significant challenges, you're going through a difficult time with family members, worried about their health, see where the opportunities are. Look for the opportunities. That's one of the benefits of watching a show like us and hearing from us is we're biased towards finding opportunities even in dark times.
Yeah, very good. Well, from us here at Real Money Real Estate, we want to thank you all. We'll see you on the next one. If you ever have any questions, you are obviously able to email us or write us in. You can find us on Roku and on YouTube and on Facebook. And if anything, please let us know. Have a great day.
Awesome.